Mike, Ace Beverage Group is going to be the first of its kind in Canada to launch a carb-free beer. It seems like our neighbors to the south have done this with Bud Light Next. When I think of beer and zero carbs, it equals zero taste to me.
Yeah, that's we agree when we first started out on the journey to develop this product. And as you mentioned, there is a product in the US, Bud Light Next, which we've tried. In our opinion, it does kind of lack the true beer taste. That was the biggest challenge in developing this product. We set out to do this about 2.5 years ago. One of our executives started this really as a passion project and eventually really dove into the science and the research, starting by converting the carbs into alcohol. But then the biggest challenge was taste. How do you get a carb-free beer to taste amazing, taste just as good or better than existing light beers? And we believe that's what we've done with the Ace Hill carb-free beer.
Do you think ultimately you're going to find your niche in this market?
Yeah, absolutely. We think there's a huge opportunity for better for you innovation overall in beverage alcohol. That's what's been spurring growth for our company and across the industry over the last few years. Beer in particular has been a very interesting category. Beer remains the largest beverage alcohol category in the world, but the category has been flat or declining over the last few years. And one of the main reasons for that is this overall shift to better for you beverages. And that's where we really saw this opportunity to bring consumers back to a product that they love. Beer is one of the most, you know, beloved and satisfying beverages in the world, but consumers have become so conscious of calories, carbs, and sugar. And that was really the opportunity for us to develop a product that could both taste amazing with a proper, crisp beer taste and deliver on the better for you attributes that consumers are expecting in today's environment.
So indulge us here with some shameless self-promotion. When you take a look at the neighbors to the south with that Bud Light Next, how do you guys compare? What do they taste like?
It's been interesting for us because when we started developing the Ace Hill carb-free beer about 2.5 years ago, no one else had done it in the world. We didn't even know if it was possible. So we kind of set out to do a bunch of R&D and, you know, went through dozens of product and brewing innovations and iterations to get to where we are. And then we saw this year Bud Light, you know, from the largest beverage alcohol company in the world, launching Bud Light Next with a large marketing spend, including Super Bowl ads and things like that. We were really excited to try the product. I guess in the name of shameless self-promotion, we were a little bit disappointed. The liquid is very different than ours. It's very light, so it doesn't really have what we would consider a true beer taste. If you blind taste test, which we've done extensively in our early consumer trials against existing light beers or against the Ace Hill carb-free beer, it has a much lighter taste. It's much more noticeable. The Ace Hill carb-free beer tastes just like any other light beer that consumers are used to, but delivers on a superior, better for you value proposition. And that's why we're so excited about this product innovation.
Let's just dive into your books here for a moment. Sure. How do you balance with these constant conversations around inflation? How do you balance those margins and versus, I guess, passing on those costs to consumers? Has that already made its way down to consumers?
Yeah, great question. It's been a pretty crazy environment, as you're aware, recently and over the past few years, really. The macroeconomic conditions have been quite challenging, whether it's labor shortages, shortages of raw material inputs, rising fuel costs. All of those things affect our supply chain and affect the industry overall, which drives increased costs around inputs like cans, for example. Cans and lids would be a big one. We've been able to, we have a quite a profitable and high margin business model. We've been able to kind of weather the storm a little bit. We're going to see, you know, a few basis points off of our gross margin this year, but still a pretty healthy gross margin and EBITDA margin. There haven't been huge price increases yet that have been passed on to the consumer. So we're kind of watching to see where those trends go. We expect there will be some price increases as there are every year. But so far, the impact has been manageable and we've been able to mitigate it just through our financial discipline and the success of our products.
Let's go back a little bit. You had touched on aluminum. How closely are you watching what happens to aluminum to barley?
Yeah, we're watching all these components of the supply chain. We will go through about 50 million cans this year as we've been growing quickly and scaling up. So we're very sensitive about these inputs. One thing we've done that's been quite interesting is we've actually released a whole new format in the ready-to-drink category, mostly under our Cottage Springs brand, which is our leading brand at Ace Beverage Group. And that's the bag-in-box format. So that's actually a carton-based format, like a giant adult juice box almost, a four-liter bag-in-box. And that innovation was partly driven by the sensitivity to the can issue, which has been going on for years. There were tariffs around aluminum in the Trump administration, and it's been a very sensitive aspect of the supply chain. So we kind of deal with it in a few ways. We monitor what the latest trends are, and we look to address those through our product portfolio.
You have shared that the beer business, specifically your business, has been affected, but I guess by some of the same issues that have been affecting other industries, cost increases, cost of ingredients, energy, transport. You haven't touched on labor. Has that been a challenge for your company?
Labor, thankfully, hasn't been a direct challenge for us. We haven't seen, you know, the great resignation and things of that nature at our company. We're about 80 employees today based in Toronto. Very young, energetic, enthusiastic workforce. It's a fun place to work based on the brands that we have with Cottage Springs and Ace Hill and a few others, and the kind of innovation that we're doing and the growth and performance that we're seeing in the market. So we've been largely insulated in terms of our core business. Where we see the impact is more across our supply chain with our supply partners. We have a co-packing model, so we produce our products with a variety of co-packing partners in Ontario and across Canada. And certainly we see labor shortages affecting various aspects of the supply chain. But directly at Ace Beverage Group, thankfully we've got a very engaged and awesome workforce that's happy to come to work, sample all of our products, work on innovation, and you know, just showing a lot of passion and enthusiasm for our mission.
And just before we let you go, the Ace Hill carb-free beer on LCBO store shelves, just in time for summer. No mistaking the timing there.
Yeah, of course. So the Ace Hill carb-free beer is rolling out onto LCBO shelves basically starting today. So it's going to be available across Ontario this week and into next week. Very exciting, good time for us, despite the recent snowfall. As we see in Ontario, it takes a little bit of time for the spring to kick in, but we worked really hard to get this product out in time for the peak selling season, and very excited to get it into the hands of consumers over the next few weeks.